hidden manna that you promise in the book of Revelation. I promise, Heavenly Father, to deliver it as the Spirit leads. But my request is singular. May you please, oh Lord, give me some of the hidden manna, so that I and my brothers and sisters can eat and be filled. In Christ's name we pray, amen. Hebrews chapter 5, verse
8.
Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8. Saifunda yesintu, then I'll read it in English.
Hebrews 8, ityona. Loba eyindodana wafunda ukulalela ngalokho ahlupheka ngakho.
Please read it again.
Loba eyindodana wafunda ukulalela ngalokho ahlupheka ngakho.
Others are still opening. Well, it's supposed to be ahlupheka. Yes, ahlupheka. Okay, the others are still opening the Bible. Are we all there?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Please, my elder, if you don't mind, read it again.
Loba eyindodana wafunda ukulalela ngalokho ahlupheka ngakho.
Yebo, my elder. I'm sorry, man. I'm also a linguist. So it's supposed to be, can I read it? Can I read it, my other friend? It's supposed to be... Loba eyindoda wafunda ukulalela ngalokho ahlupheka ngakho. Though he was a son.
Loba wayeyindodana.
Though he was a son,
Noba wayeyindodana,
yet he learned obedience by the things which he saw.
Wafunda ukulalela ngalokho ahlupheka ngakho.
And this subject this morning,
udaba lwethu namhlanje,
is the humility of Christ.
Ukuzehlisa kukaKristu.
The humility of Christ.
Ukuzehlisa kukaKristu.
My elders, I don't see a clock in front of me. It would have been good if I had a watch. Dalanyat. Okay, Nazi watch. Hallelujah. I was saying to my elders that relationships are most important than preaching. I remember at one church, a friend of mine finished preaching before I was a pastor. This friend of mine finished preaching and is greeting people at the door. So an elderly man comes there to him.
We thank you. Of what you've done to us today.
Relationships are important than preaching. But this is the humility of
Christ.
When we are talking about the humility of Christ, we are not talking about what he came to be when he was here on planet Earth. Though it is part of it, it is part of it, but that's not where it begins. So when we are speaking about the humility of Christ, what Philippians chapter 2 speaks about, and that though he was God, he did not consider it robbery. It's not talking about while he came here on earth. Now, from what our preacher Let me go back in time. Let me go so far back in time. Before time began. Now it is not befitting for me to refer it as time. That the human mind cannot compute it. So far back in eternity, before the Father and the Son created an angel, when they sat there in their holiness, if their attitude of love, when they sat just the two of them, before there was Lucifer, before there was Gabriel, and God the Father and His Son, there was God before nobody could pray. Somehow, when you buy this little girl a doll, this child knows that this teddy bear must be loved. Who has shamed this child? Who has shamed the child? There is something in the child that ought to be cuddled, but nobody has taught the child that you need to hold it close. You need to love it. And when somebody hits this door, there is a pain in her little heart. She feels a pain. But with no object to bestow the love. Therefore, and so the Almighty got the ball of creation rolling. And He created them angels. But He created Lucifer.
Was it Dala or Lucifer?
By the way, who's creating?
Mubani or Dala Yola?
A hand?
No, one of the sons.
Who's creating?
Mubani or Dala?
Go and read Hebrews chapter 1, the whole chapter.
Habani de Funda, Abba Eberu chapter 1, the new thing.
It is the Son that creates.
Indotala, Edala.
And so when He creates, He creates Lucifer, makes him so brilliant, and He makes him to look like himself. There was nothing in all creation At that time, planet Earth has not been created.
Umhlaba ngaleso sikhathi awukadalwa.
Let me not use the word time.
Ngingasebenzisi igama elithi isikhathi.
Because time at that time was not existing.
Ngoba isikhathi ngaleso sikhathi sasingekho.
So let me say, at that moment it intended.
Asithi ukuthi ngalowo mzuzu dala.
Nothing resembled the creator like Lucifer. When you read Spirit of Prophets Volume 1, she tells us that God created
Lucifer
and made him to resemble him. And that's why he thought he could be God.
Yikho-ke wacabanga yena ukuthi sengafana noNkulunkulu.
But creation was not done.
Indalo beyingakapheleleli.
Creation was not done.
Indalo ukudala beyingakapheleli.
Then a consultation took place.
Waba nokuxhumana nokukhulumisana.
Consultation took place.
Waba nokukhulumisana.
And then God said.
UNkulunkulu wasesithi.
Deity said.
UNkulunkulu onamandla uthi yena.
So the way I'm using the word God.
Indlela engisebenzisa ngalo igama elithi uNkulunkulu.
It's like how we would say the presidency.
Kufana nje nokuthi sithi nje umongameli.
Well, not really umongameli. I know it's difficult to translate this one, but iskhosi.
Yes, maybe the presidency.
Yes, iskhosi. Now, when you are saying royalty, you are not really speaking about the king himself alone. But you are speaking about his whole entourage. His whole office, the kitchen staff. Everything. And so when I'm saying deity,
it is
in that sense. So I'm speaking about the Father and the Son. Now, so that you are not lost, let me just give you a very quick hierarchy of the beings that exist. Now, yes, right, now, we are, I did not say human being. One creature at a time. And I'm preaching. Okay? Thank you. Right? You listen to me, isn't it? Good. One creature at a time. So I'm not saying human beings, I'm saying beings. So he has a very quick hierarchy.
I think the one is a church.
A very quick one. We still have time. We have what is called the divine beings. The divine beings is the Father and the Son. Then the second beings are the holy beings who do not know sin experientially. The unfallen worlds and the angels. Remember, they know what sin is. But they don't know it experientially like you and me. Then under them, you have what is called the human being. But the human beings have fallen. We are now fallen beings. Now under the fallen human beings,
They
have fell far low below us.
And
they do not have a plan of salvation.
The
reason why they have fallen far below us, in our fallenness,
it is because
if you've been writing notes, put a star. It is because they know Jehovah
first.
There is no any other way to save them. For they have seen the great I am. They know his capability. They know his indescribable love. Salvation. And this is why they are below us. So then God decides, let us make man in our image. And this was a big problem. I am he that resembles God. Who is this now to be created in the image of God? Who is this now who is to be the crown of creation? But before God created, He knew everything.
Why was it okay?
I will not spend time answering how come, Pastor.
And so then get this cut in food, who did that went around in food.
We will leave that lesson for another day.
Jesus, here, let us food. Yes,
I could answer it.
Yeah,
but our time does not allow.
God, this cut said to us,
but God knew.
What do you know?
He knew what would happen.
Why was he going on?
Let me go a little bit further. As we sit here this morning, God knows who's going to heaven and who's not. But listen carefully on what I'm about to say about that. God knows who's going and who's not. Now the knowledge of God, which is called the omniscience of God, the all-knowingness of God, it does not mean, it does not equate to predestination.
God knows. He knows who is going to go and who is not going to go. But his knowledge, his love cannot be equated to saying it is predestined who is going to go with.
So omniscience
and
predestination are not the same. And so God says, let's create
man.
But before he had created man, there had to be a contemplation. Before he created Lucifer, there was some deep thinking. And the deep thinking was, when men fall, what are we going to do? And so God thought.
uNkulunkulu wasecabanga.
And the Bible calls that the Council of Peace.
uNkulunkulu iBhayibheli lithi lona kwaba umhlangano wokuthula.
And the spirit of prophecy speaks about the Father and the Son.
The spirit of prophecy yakhuluma ngobaba nendodana.
They are sitting there in a meeting.
Bahleli basemhlanganweni.
God,
uNkulunkulu,
being counseled by himself.
Exoxisana naye.
God being advised by himself.
uNkulunkulu ecabanga yena yedwa.
You see, the book of Hebrews says,
when
God made an oath to Abraham,
uNkulunkulu ma enika isithembiso kuAbraham,
he had to make an oath and swear by himself.
Amele wenza isithembiso wasefunga ngaye.
And God there by himself.
uNkulunkulu yedwa.
The Bible says God had to swear by himself.
uNkulunkulu wamele afunge ngaye.
Because there wasn't anybody greater than him.
Ngoba wayengekho oyangaphezu kwakhe.
He was the final arbiter. And so God being the constitutional court. The Father and the Son, they are talking. And here was the problem. The problem was, it was possible for Jesus to fall in sin. It was possible for him to be tarnished by one sin. It was possible for his son to never ever again return in that golden home. By the way, God also knew what would have happened if men had not fallen in sin.
We are
told in the story of redemption what would have happened.
Just briefly,
she says, if men had not fallen in sin, if Adam had not fallen in sin, man was going to grow in understanding. And finally would reach the level of angels. That's what would have happened. Briefly. But time will not allow us to tell us.
For us.
So God knowing the cost.
uNkulunkulu esazi konke okwenzakala.
Is there a single young man and a single young lady?
Ukhona mhlawumbe ongashadanga intombazana lejaha.
Please stand up.
Cela liphakame.
I am Izoshadisa.
I'm not going to marry you.
Please stand up. Stand up, I want to make a quick example. Come, single man, single young lady, come. I knew that a lady would stand up. Women are often more brave,
huh?
I want to ask you the same question. I would like to believe, this is a question, but I'm putting it this way. I would like to believe that both of you one day would love the Lord to bless you with a godly partner. Yes? If it's yes, just put your hand up. Yes? Hallelujah. I would like to believe that one day you would like to have a child. I would like to believe that you would love a son or a daughter. Now, listen to what I'm going to say now, and I'm going to ask you the same question. Do you know that your son
Siyawazi ukuthi umntana wenu
or your daughter
or when
I'm done in but umntana akho since I'm not really saying I'm never used to it. So your child,
umntana akho,
your beautiful daughter,
indodakazi yakho enhle,
she can become the greatest prostitute this world has ever known.
Engaba isisebe esikhulu esinamandla okwedlula wonke umuntu emhlabeni.
I'm not saying she will.
Angisho ukuthi uzoba.
I'm saying there is a possibility.
Kungenzeka ukuthi abe yinkolono.
In a world of sin, there's a possibility.
Yeah, emhlabeni wesono esiphila kuwo kungenzeka lokho.
It is possible also for your son.
Kungenzeka futhi ukuthi indodana yakho
to be the greatest serial killer this world and the greatest rapist this world has ever known.
Angaba umuntu nje obulalayo or odlwengulayo ilizwe leli elingakazela imboni.
In a world of sin, we are talking about possibilities.
Emhlabeni wesono sikhuluma ngento ezingenzeka.
Here I'm not challenging your parentness, your parenthoodness towards the child. That's not what I'm talking about.
Angikhulumi ukuthi mhlawumbe ningaba ningabazali nizoba abazali abangekho right.
I'm saying all things being equal, there is that possibility.
Ngithi mina amanto zihamba nje kungenzeka ukuthi lento le yenzeke.
Now,
manje,
church, I need you to look at them when I'm going to ask this question. Look at them.
Ngeli bandla libabheke ma ngizofunda ngizobuza lo mbuzo.
Would you still like the Lord to bless you with a godly partner and for you to have a son or a daughter? If yes, put up your hand.
Noma kunjalo ningafuna yini ukuthi uNkulunkulu akubusise umuntu wazi uNkulunkulu libe nabantwana nezingane phansi anizwa.
I saw they both put up their hands.
Bonile ukuthi baphakamisile bonke.
The next question I will answer it for them. Sit down, guys. I will answer it for
them. Is there anybody
who wants to try
to
explain why they put up
their hands
regardless of that risk?
Is there
anybody? Let me answer for them. You see, when you are a human being, you love to love. And love will always involve risk. No matter what kind of love it is, when there is love, there is a risk. You see, when you are standing here, and then I say, you must say I do. Do you know what risk you are taking? You know, married people, they know. They're like, ah, no, pastor, me, I don't know. Do you know what's the risk? The risk is that when you are saying to this person, I do, you are risking that sometime in life you may not be loved back. Yes, it's a risk. When this person is saying, oh, stop, Papa Samuel,
I love you, my darling.
What do you have in hand? For assurance that this person will never ever.
Oh, niggas, it's still the same to me.
What do you have? Nothing. You have nothing. Except that you love them. So, God was love. And being love, He had to risk loving you and me. And giving us the freedom to choose. To love him or not. And it was the great risk of the universe.
When the human being will blatantly, blatantly, rudely look at God and say, I don't love you back by your actions. Others have told God blatantly, there is no God, they say. It's all just love and falsehoods that are written in the Bible. But God took a risk. The two young people that stood up, they are not foolish to take that risk. It shows that they are normal. They are made in the image of God. And the image of God in man is also to take the risk of love. Oh, I can't live without you. You know, I come from a family of eight. I'm number five. So the last two are two girls and a boy. So when they intercepted the letter,
so
written to my young sister, I had lived with my sister for
22
years. The things that were written in that letter, I had seen them in my soul. I was
shocked.
She has eyes like a moon.
How?
You are my everything. You are my everything, said
God. This person that I'm pulling and fighting with every day.
She's all this.
We don't want to know.
That's love. And imagine how God saw the possibility in the human being.
When
a man says, I love you, I'm speaking about a Christian godly man.
A
mature man. In essence, what he is saying is, I see endless possibilities. Endless possibilities. With you and me making our children. I remember, you see, when I was at school, I was the one who was writing love letters for other guys, and I used to make them pay. And I was good at it. And I had a line, that everybody began to lie. Where I used to say, you see, when I see you, now, can you imagine, this is a Form 4 student. And I'm writing, I'm saying, when I see you, in your eyes,
what am I seeing?
Can't talk about the kitchen, my
children playing in your eyes.
Well, I had heard this from my uncle.
My uncle's an old man.
Who had said somebody, when I'm to have a ministry now,
saying, I see my children in your eyes.
But I didn't think that was nice.
I didn't
think that was poetic. So I thought, no, let me see their animal playing.
I think it's been a bad kitchen, my man.
And it sounded so nice. And so this man sees endless possibilities in this world. Do you know what God saw in
man?
The possibilities of what God saw in the human being.
Into us bonayo ezingaphediyo emuntwini.
They have never been measured.
Azake azinamkhawulo.
They are impossible to measure.
Ngeke nje uzifake umthawulo.
So when men fell in sin,
umuntu ma wawela ewela esonweni.
Esintwini sasithi ngaze ngakhumula ibhatshi.
In our language we say I removed my jacket.
That's what God did.
Ayikho lokho uNkulunkulu akwenzayo.
When man was falling in sin,
umuntu wayesewela esonweni.
God knew what it implied.
God knew what was.
And because of the possibilities that God has seen in man.
Ngenxa yalokhu okuhlaya kubona umuntu.
Which man has never seen in himself.
Yena umuntu angakaze abone kuye.
So when man falls in sin,
ma umuntu ewela esonweni.
God takes off his jacket.
UNkulunkulu uyakhipha ijazi lakhe.
And he puts it there. And he looks at his son.
Uyabheka indodana yakhe.
His only begotten son. And he says to his son, this is what we spoke about. Before we created heaven, I'm not talking about earth. Before we created heaven, for well, what makes heaven is the presence of God. What makes heaven heaven is the presence of God. But before before all created intelligences, beings from the unfallen worlds were created. Well, amen, church. Before all these were created, and the Father says, Son, my only begotten Son, I know that there is a possibility that you may not return. But this is what we spoke about. And so in the Council of Peace, when Ellen White is describing it, she says, behold, I saw the Almighty sitting on his throne, and the Son went into the midst of him. And when he and when he entered there, they had an intense discussion. And the risk was that the son may not return. And an agreement was not settled. Because the father was in agony. You see, when we speak about Gethsemane and Calvary, we always speak about the excruciating pain that Christ went through. We always speak about the agony of the Son at the cross. But none has preached about the agony of the Father. Go to a father and he will tell you, I would rather be crucified than my son. But there was a science, brothers and sisters. There was a science.
There was a silence that was happening in that council.
And then when he says, I saw the sign, the sun went in again the second time.
The
son, the
daughter,
he went into the father again, and the council of peace, and there was a discussion between the two, but the father was in agony, because God, he does not need an experience to know how the thing feels. He knows exactly what it feels like to be a sinner. The Almighty Father in eternity together and his son, they felt the pain.
They
felt the shuddering dread
of
what they were going to go through
when
it happens practically, when it happens in Calvary. They felt that in eternity. This is why the Bible says he was slain from the foundation of the earth.
Humility be in us, in Christ's name, amen.